Okay guys, here we are with the Superior Ring Bending Tool from Pepe Tools, and I want to show you all the things that we can do with this. I've been using this all summer, especially with sterling silver square wire, and I just love working with it. So, here's what you end up getting, and the first thing that you get is you get this kind of heavy tool that's going to be our bending tool. We're going to put this in the vise using our copper tongs so that we protect the base of it. The other thing that you'll see is a handle, and you just take this handle and you just screw it into the side. That's it. So, you see all of these parts are for making ring bending tools, and so here's a part. This one says 16, and so we can see the 16 here, and then there's a corresponding part that fits it that also says 16. And so this is going to be ideal for making rings. And then you can also see that there's a Delrin plastic part. So I'm using, almost all the time, I'm using this Delrin plastic part because it's not marring my sterling silver wire. So, but there is an option of using the metal one that is provided, and you can see that it is numbered and it fits directly next to it as well. And we also use that one because maybe we're working with stainless steel or something that's harder. Another one that I want to show you is these bending mechanisms. And so what we're going to end up doing is we'll take this one and put it in the hole, and then I'm going to show how to bend the metal soon by taking that corresponding one, putting it in there, and then we'll put it in the vise and we'll bend. And so I'm going to show you how all of those work. I'm really looking forward to you seeing this tool. It'll be stored in the studio, and you'll be welcome to use it. Just make sure that all the parts end up where they need to go. Thank you. Okay, so here we are. I have it set up in the vise, and there's a natural dip that's built into this so that it sets really flat into the vise. Make sure that you use copper tongs or that you put leather here, because this vise is really aggressive and I don't want it to bite into the bottom of the tool. This tool also has locations here where it could be screwed into a table or into pieces of wood. But for our studio space, I think it'll work to just keep it something that can be mobile. So I have some sterling silver square wire that I've rolled in a rolling mill, and it's annealed. And then I've gotten it as straight as I can just using a planishing hammer on the anvil. But it's still relatively soft. And I'm going to use this 60 degree turning bending tool. And so I have the 60 degree tool first. It's a little bit clunky if you don't put that one in first. And then I put the 60 degree in there. And then I measure out where I want it to be, and I'm going to keep this nice and level. So just like everything with bending, I still have to keep this parallel to the plane. If I have it going wonky, obviously the bend is going to be incorrect. And then all I do, check it. Oh, that is so awesome. And then there I am with my bend. Now what I have been doing is I've actually even gotten more of that bend out by just keeping it on a flat surface and using like my ruler to push this against the anvil, and then I can get it bent even more if I want to. But that's a perfect 60. And it barely bites into the edge here of the sterling, but it is not very much to the point that I can actually just go ahead and file that out and sand that out. So this is the only one of the tools that doesn't have the Delrin piece, but you could certainly make your own so that you don't mar it. But I really love how that works. So let me show you how the ring bender works as well. Okay, so here we are with the ring bender. And again, I've created this sterling silver square wire that's annealed. And for this one, I just took it to the anvil with a little rawhide mallet. So I really want it nice and soft so that I get a good curve with my ring bender. So I have the number 18, and then I found the Delrin piece that fits it. And I'm going to put it in there. And same thing, I have to keep it really level. And so these are the things that it's really helpful if you already knew how to use a mandrel and a hammer, because the same techniques apply. And so I'm going to start to make my circle. And then I'm going to barely move it and barely move it, and then I can get that circle to form perfectly. You do need to make sure that you kind of do, just like with a hammer where we have overlapping blows, you're going to have overlapping pinches on it so that it's going to be nice and flat. And I can do this more like whenever we're making jump rings where I can overlap itself a little bit. And I can even go all the way to that perfect circle. And so it overlaps here. I usually take that to my bench and I cut it right there. And then I've got these perfect, perfect circles. And everything is really flat. That is ready to just make into a flat earring. I can hit it probably once on an anvil with a rawhide and it's ready to go. So my guess is you guys are gonna fall in love with this tool like I did. Don't forget that we still have mandrels and hammers, and so you can still make stuff if you don't have this, but oh my goodness, I'm definitely buying it for myself now. All right, have fun.